1001 Nights.
Yo, Dawg.
This game is crazy. This is a game where you play characters who themselves are playing characters in a role-playing game within the game.
So, you're in a Sultan's court, 1001 Nights, right? You're not the Sultan. The Sultan is this... You don't even talk to the Sultan. He's not really a character. It's just sort of like this imaginary object in the game, right? That you worry... You don't want to make the Sultan upset, and you also don't want to get executed or, you know, kicked out.
No, you play a character. Like, I was playing the Don Juan, the poet, the court poet. I'm this pretty boy, lover boy. That's the dude I'm playing.
Yeah, I didn't play in that game, but our friend Pete did, and he was the eunuch.
Mustafa bin Mustafa.
Great name. Not and racist at all.
Now, the way you make characters in this game is you write down, for each sense, the five senses, something about your character. He smells of lavender. He sees power in others. Whatever you want. You have to focus everything based on the senses. And for every other character sitting around the table, you write what you envy about them. So Mustafa bin Mustafa envied my virility. I envied his physical strength. It forces you to have an already existing internal relationship with every other character.
So when you get to sit down and actually play the game, what happens is all of the characters are sitting in the Sultan's court, talking to each other.
Doing their thing.
Just doing their thing. All right, so now it's you, real world, and you have a character. The character is Mustafa bin Mustafa, whatever, talking to the other characters, right? You role-play this out. Eventually, during the role-playing, somebody will, in character, say, "Let me tell you a story about that."
That
and
character.
And now, all of the characters in the game have new characters in that story. You might think it's hard to do, but it's actually incredibly easy. Like, once you sit down, and the book is a tiny book. You think, how can this tiny book make this happen? It's never failed to work.
Yeah.
Even people who are usually not good at role-playing always get it right. They remember every character's name. And not just the character that they are's name, the character in the second story's name. Right? Can't even remember D&D characters' names, but I can remember these guys' names, except Drist and...
You don't even know anything about the Forgotten Realms.
The Forgotten Realms. No, I know about you talking about Forgotten Realms all the time.
It's a big part of my life and my youth.
Yeah.
The other cool thing about this game, so you're playing these characters playing characters, and part of the reason it's easy is that because you're playing a character is always simpler than you. At least I hope it's simpler than you. Otherwise you spend way too much time writing that backstory. So as a result, you have a very simple focus. You have this very simple lens through which to view the secondary character that that character's playing. Coupled with the fact that the character's playing a character in the context of the Sultan's court, you get into situations where the eunuch, wanting to take the wind out of my sails, starts to tell the story of Don Juan, you know, the epic lover. And he assigns himself the role of the epic lover. He assigns me, the epic lover, the role of the eunuch, to put me in my place.
So now you've got a story where you got a guy role-playing a eunuch who is telling a story in which the eunuch is role-playing the Don Juan, and then you got a Grimm playing a Don Juan who is in that story role-playing the eunuch.
So I come onto the stage when I'm introduced, herp de dur, I'm the eunuch, big and stupid, I sure wish I had balls. I insulted him at the second level. The book also tells you to eat figs and dates and olives and lounge while playing.
We did that, because in New York you can get Turkish delivery.
This game is amazing, and I highly, it actually just recently got re-released.
Recently reprinted, new edition.
Yeah.
Worth every dollar. Yo, Dawg.
So if I'm going to tell the story of my character here, I'm not going to talk about my strength stat. That's not interesting. And it turns out that that's the only part of my character that is character, that is story, who he knows, what he's done, where he's going, why he fights for what he fights for. That's it. And that whole character sheet, that's it.
Yeah, so, you're trying to tell me this is a role-playing game, but what percentage of it has anything to do with role-playing? That percent. And most of that is a picture.
Now, you've been...